So there are a lot of different ways to convert currency values in numbers. Let's take a look at some of the functions. I'm going to start a formula here by hitting the equals key. And then on the right I'm going to search in functions for things that have to do with currency. So let me search for currency. And you can see that there are four different functions here. So let's jump ahead and take a look at currency convert, which is a really simple one. So we look at the function here and it's currency convert value into a currency code. So we could start with that. We'll convert, say if I want to convert $10, and since I'm set to be US English for the language, it's going to assume dollars. So 10, but I'm going to convert to euro. So I'm going to use the currency code for euro, E-U-R, as a string inside quotes. And I'm going to get a result there. Now another thing I could have done is I could have provided a string here with a currency value in it. So 10 with the dollar sign. And it would work. And that's one way to deal with making sure that you're in the right currency, is use a string instead of a number. Now if I was actually going to use something like $100 in here and it's formatted as dollars, then it would pick it up and make sure it uses the right currency. So I'll do currency convert. I'll select this cell as the value and I'll use the euro as the code. So that's a pretty simple way to do it. And it's going to take the number from the previous day's close. So it's not a live currency update, but it's close enough. It's just what it was at the end of yesterday. So for exact calculations you may want to have some more sophisticated financial software, but for just general things with what today's price is, this will work. Now let's take a look at some of the other functions. So we'll delete this formula here and we'll look at currency. So currency, what it will do is convert from one currency to another and give you the price. So for instance I can do currency and I can say US dollars to euro, and what it'll give me is basically how much $1 is in euros. I can put another parameter here and you can see there's a list of them. There's change, percent change, open, high, low, 52 week high, etc., etc. So I could basically go with, say, the open price from yesterday and it will give me that. So you have some more functionality there. Now there are also some other ones here. There's currency H, which is historical. So not only can you get a lot of that same data for the current day, but you can also set a date. So you can go say what was it the end of last week or a year ago, that kind of thing. There's also a currency code function which will tell you the code for a given value. So if I were to do, let's say, currency code, select this, which I know is a dollar amount, I'm going to see that it's in US dollars. If this was in euros, then it would put EUR. Now how about these codes? What do you figure out, how do you figure out what they are? So you can see here in the description for all these functions that it says that the currency codes are defined by ISO 4217. So if we simply search for 4217, we can find that in Wikipedia and quickly get to the table here where it tells you codes for different countries and currencies.